Hello folks, Phil Gallagher, aka ThrabenU, here for another vintage video. We're going to old, powerful, and broken cards, even more so than Legacy. Alex B donated to see some Bazaar of Baghdad aggro. For those of you familiar with the Legacy Madvine deck that I played a ton with on my channel a year or so ago, we wanted to dump in a bunch of Blazing Rootwallas or Basking Rootwallas and attack with a Vengevine. And that was all cool and good, and sometimes we got the hollow ones in the mix as well with things like Burning Inquiry or Faithless Looting. Well, spoilers. In Vintage you have arguably one of the most broken lands of all time, but Vintage is the home for those cards. Things like Talarian Academy, Strip Mine, those cards are legal here. And of course, like the Mishra's Workshops that the shops archetype is built around. The Bazaar is going to let us draw two cards and discard three cards. Oh, that's card disadvantage. That's bad, right? Yeah, no, it's totally bad. Unless you maybe build your entire deck around that card, and would arguably mulligan to one card to find it. We are going to abuse this card using Squee, Goblin, Nabob, and Master of Death. These cards basically do the same thing. At the beginning of your upkeep, you can return them from your graveyard to your hand, although Master of Death costs you one life in order to do so. So essentially what we're looking to do here is get some creatures into play at a highly discounted or free cost and beat our opponent to death while using some pitch cards like Force of Will, Force of Negation, and Force of Vigor as sort of tempo plays. If you can just dump a hollow one or a Vengevine into play on turn one or two and then protect it with like two free spells, like you're going to get an absurd amount of damage in very quickly. So I don't have too much else to say about this. This deck goes deeper than a lot of other decks in the format in that it's playing Serum Powder so that you can take a free mulligan and have another shot at getting Bazaar. More or less, a Bazaar deck will keep any hand that has a Bazaar. Like, the card is just that good. It digs you to what you need, and you will eventually overpower your opponent. The sideboard is incredibly pointed here. We have 8 cards for like graveyard-oriented decks like Dredge. We have 7 cards for Unfair Combo. I'm going to have to think about subtlety a little bit. This is not a card that I've really played with before. When it enters the battlefield, choose up to one target creature or creature spell or planeswalker spell. The owner puts it on the top or bottom of their library. So this can be a fair counterspell versus creature decks that you can use to replace something like Force of Negation that might not be ideal. I think with that being said, let's just hop into some matches. Let's play some like high-octane, high-power Magic today. If you're new here and you like what you see, please consider subscribing. And if you're a regular, throw me a like before this video begins. That sort of thing really matters on these Vintage videos, which might not necessarily do as well as my Legacy ones, although they're always fun to play. Let's battle. Okay, so I think I just mulligan this hand. I have like 5 looks at a Bazaar or I lose the game. And if this gets countered, I also just lose the game. So let's just powder this hand. Oh, I see. I put a card back before I powder. I guess I want to put back a hollow one. Okay, I've got a Bazaar now. I will keep all of these. I believe I go ahead and cast this. I'll look for a Vengevine here. Go ahead and drop a Bazaar. Go ahead and activate this now. Discard Vengevine, Rootwalla, Rootwalla. Okay, Madness fans, this is what you've been waiting for. Let us choose Violence. Mental Misstep. Absolutely, that's fine. What matters is that I cast these, not that they resolve. The Vengevine is the real prize here anyway. So we have 5 power in play on turn 1, backed by a Force of Will or Force of Negation. I need this upkeep stop back. Took it off because I was near timing out in something else that I recorded. I'll let your Pearl resolve. White, green. I shouldn't read much into the Mox Pearl here. Well, that's annoying. That gets around Force of Will and Force of Negation. Do I have anything? No. Okay. Now a little bit scarier. Serum Powder not doing a lot here. And I don't think I'm supposed to Force of Will the Mox Pearl, but I did very much get punished for not doing it. Like, I draw a green card and then I just Force of Vigor it instead a little bit later. Opponent is naming Oof. That's fine. Your Collector Oof is also fine. Mox Pearl is now off. Vengevine still gets to get into the red zone. Rootwalla is chilling, though. The Ignoble Hierarch jumping in the way? No. So I now have two active counter spells here, and presumably there's not more Collector Oofs. Okay. Do I care? I just still have Force of Will for the next thing. So I guess I take that out. I just don't care about that. Like, once I have a threat in play, specifically, that just doesn't matter anymore. I guess I could have let that resolve and just Force of Vigored it later. If we'll see if Collector Oof is chump blocking this turn. Okay, it is. My opponent stays at 5. They have a little bit more mana. I have Force of Will for whatever spell they play. I don't have lethal. I have close to lethal. No. It's not like the cards my opponent are playing are particularly good here. I think I'm just going for them because my opponent is hellbent. Send him. Alright, jumping in front of Vengevine here. My opponent goes to 4. If they brick on a creature this turn, they are dead. What you got? Alright, they bricked on a creature. I don't know why they're playing what they're playing. Yeah, it does not particularly seem like a vintage deck. Like, it's a pile of hate cards that are vintage legal, but it doesn't feel powerful. I don't even know that I sideboard. Like, I have the Force of Vigors in my deck already, which is what I would kind of want. I can keep the Force of Negations for Blood Moons. I could play a couple subtleties. I think I'm just going to click the submit button again. All right, no Bazaar here. Easy mulligan. Bazaar here. Easy keep. With both Force of Will and Force of Vigor here as protection stuff. This should be pretty solid. The Serum Powder is not going to do me any favors. We'll get rid of that. See what my opponent has to do over there. There literally could be anything. Armagoyf. Do I care? Doesn't really do anything right now. But it's kind of like make this decision now. Or it's on the board for the rest of the game. I guess I'll take it out. I don't know about this decision. I literally have no experience playing against whatever my opponent's deck is, if it even is established enough to have a name. Alright, let's Bazaar. I just put 6 power in play and pitch the Force of Vigor. I think I'll do 5 power and pitch Squee. Oh my god, I clicked on Hollow One. That was very obviously supposed to be Noxious Revival. I am upset at myself. For target artifact or enchantment, that's fine. That's also fine. Alright. Let's return Squee. There's a new Hollow One. I'm just going to go ahead and Noxious Revival a Hollow One back to my deck now that I have another one here. So let's activate this. Oh my god. Discard 1. 2, 3. Madness that into play. Storm is 2. Storm is 3. Storm is 4. I just did a stupid thing in not playing Hollow One last turn. Let's see if I recovered from it just by being an objectively powerful deck. Mox Emerald is fine. Okay, yeah. We can come on back. Alright, cool. I technically should have activated Bazaar first in case I found another Vengevine. A small error on my end. Sure. Yeah, I don't care about a Lightning Bolt. Alright, so then my opponent will probably sacrifice to blow up a different one. Mitigate the amount of damage that they take in this exact turn cycle. That brings my opponent to 15. All Bazaar. Second Bazaar, or just put another Hollow One in play. I probably just put another Hollow One in play. Just get this game over with. Are we done? No immediate concession. Endurance. Guess I just let that happen. And activate Naked Bazaar in my upkeep. Just put some new cards in graveyard. Dump in a lizard. Cast it. But once upon a time that I am very much not casting. And we'll basically have my opponent's life total again. Oh wow, they're taking out a Rootwalla. Going to three. So this is where my opponent would have been dead in theory if I had played out the Hollow One properly instead of just being dumb. Okay, we win the match anyway. There was a gulf in power level between our decks, and it showed. Alright, no Bazaar, we mulligan. No Bazaar, we mulligan. Bazaar, we keep. There's an unhealthy number of Noxious Revivals. I assume I just toss back two of those. Keep one in case my Bazaar gets wastelanded. Alright, we are playing against a blue deck. That's all we know. Are we getting Ancestral? Nope. Oh! This format too, huh? It has been a hot minute since I have played some Vintage. I enjoy the format a lot, though. Let's just assume that I start doing this immediately. Vengevine. Master. I'm thinking about whether or not I need Force of Negation up. I'm gonna go no. And try to get my value out of these cards. Alright, no Wasteland or Strip Mine, which is good for me. Merchant Scroll is cool. Dunking a Force. And hand, that's in hand. Can take a little love tap. Now, the life points are relevant because Master of Death does cost me life, but it's essentially one life to draw a card or no other resource expended, which is quite strong. I haven't cast a spell, have I? Yeah, I haven't cast a spell. Let's do this. Oh, my opponent has no counter magic. That's good to know. Prized Amalgam or Rootwalla. I think I take a Rootwalla. Let's go ahead and activate this. Nice. Guard Rootwalla. Rootwalla. Master of Death. Lizard 1. Lizard 2. Return Vengevine. Make a land drop. Cast a Hollow One, Wasteland a Volcanic Island, bash in with Vengevine. I have Force of Negation available for the Ancestral that my opponent is going to cast. All right, you may surveil. Where's the Saga? All right, there's Force of Negation. There's a Force of Will. One has junked a Brainstorm. All of that is acceptable. At the end of the day, I still just have a two-turn clock in play, right? Dragon Rage Channeler now has to attack. Oh, they moved to their second main phase, which was wise of them. I don't think I need Noxious Revival. Well, drawing a Wasteland is actually kind of hot here. My opponent is low on resources as they are. Pay some life for that. I think I always just want to do that. Wasteland Underground Sea. Activate a Bazaar. A Vamp Tutor is fine. What is that going to get? Like a Lotus or something? They discard three of these. I've already made my land drop. It's unfortunate, otherwise I could be taking that out. So then this is one, two, three, I think. And we will just turn all of these sideways so that, like, I can lose a lizard or a Vengevine in an attack. That's not the end of the world here. My opponent loses their Dragon Rage Channeler. They are at six. I have theoretically lethal on board. See what they can do. I don't exactly know what I'm playing against. Like, maybe it's, like, Doomsday or something. Time Walk's not bad. Like, my opponent has to do something unfair. Okay, sure. That's not like a breach or anything. I'll pay some life here. Yes. draw. Yes, I activate this. Go up to 5 cards. I can keep Force of Negation and Master of Death in hand. All right, 1, 2, 3. That's even better. Pass that. Go to combat. Bash on in. Hollow one has to be blocked. That brings my opponent to 3, with theoretically very much more than lethal damage on board. Okay. I don't know what I'm playing against. It's combo-y. It's also got Urza Saga and Dragon Rage Channeler. Like, I assume this is something in the Breach ballpark.
But I have no idea how to sideboard.
Yeah, I think in the absence of not knowing what I'm playing against, I'm just going to resubmit the game one deck. Force of Vigor is not looking great, though. The Mindbreak Traps? Question mark, question mark? I don't know with these last couple of slots. I also don't know what... I don't know what hate to expect. I've got a Bazaar, so I'll keep. And this may be around where my inexperience with the format as it is exactly right now may cost me. My walk is good. I'll keep Vamp Tutor, which can then get an Ancestral and put it on top. They're at 18. Okay, sure. Rough, okay. I have no counterspell for that, so I need to find a Force of Vigor for that. So I'm going to just attack my opponent's mana in the short term to buy me more time against whatever it is that they're doing, and then go from there. Okay, they're stuck on mana. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right. Hard way. Get some 1-1s. It's not how you plan on winning games of Magic, but sometimes it's what you're doing. Get in there, little lizard friend. One's at 17. All right, they are taking some end of turn actions. They're getting rid of a lizard. I'll make another one and replace my clock. I might straight up just Noxious Revival another one back to the top of my deck. I've got 3 copies of Force of Vigor that I very much would like to draw, which make me not want to do that. My opponent has Stone Cold Nothing right now. Yeah, I'm going to do it. Or do I hit their Volcanic Island with Wasteland? Let's take another threat. Oh, that takes me down a card in hand, so I'm not actually discarding anymore. That was dumb. I don't know, maybe it'll still work out. I'm kind of planning on winning game 3. What is that, 15? I assume at some point I just get vintaged. I don't know when that's going to be or how it's going to happen, but it feels like my opponent will beat me in some fair or unfair capacity. All right, we're chilling, and I'm still allowed to attack with lizards. Or lizards. This feels like we both showed up for a fencing duel. We disarmed each other, and now we're just, like, flailing at each other with silly little slaps. Go, lizards, go. Would you like to Force of Will my 1-1? No. We're increasing our clock. 1, then 2, then 3. Alright, that's 1 top, 1 bottom. Alright, that's a lot of mana. Monic Tutor is scary. 4 total mana here. Okay, it is Breach. So, for those of you who haven't had the pleasure of playing against this before, you get to cast your stuff from the graveyard. And how this works is you go and you brain freeze yourself to go and put more cards into your graveyard. You then use those cards to go and recast the Lotus, you recast the brain freeze, you mill your entire library, you can switch to targeting the opponent. So I'm very dead here, just like... no way I'm coming back from it, but since I'm not super familiar with Vintage as it is now, I'm just going to take a look at their library and see what I need to play around. Okay, so my opponent has Rav Trap, and they'll freeze again. Oh, they're already at the point where they can just target me. All right, then I'll concede. I don't know how to sideboard, so like, I can do this stuff. There's that needle that I have to fight against, so I kind of want this. I wouldn't mulligan to a Ley Line of the Void. It would be cool if I had one. I could never, ever, ever cast it. Yeah, this is where I just don't have experience to know. Feels sort of like I can just try to kill my opponent. Okay, no Bazaar here. Let's just go ahead and powder this hand. Bazaar here, so I will keep. This is technically a 7-card hand. I guess Noxious Revival also kind of fights against some breach lines, technically. I'm just putting at least 5 power into play on turn 1. Like, that's where I'm at. Alright, here we go. So we Bazaar. Activate this. Discard. I probably keep Prized Amalgam to pitch to Force of Negation. Discard Lizard. Lizard, 1 Noxious Revival. Let's cast some spells. Yeah. Yeah. Free Hollow 1. Alright, it's in play. Nice. This is 6 power a turn. That is great for me to wasteland. Should I say no to that? I think I'll just say no to that. And just try to leave my opponent with minimal amounts of mana. Alright, that was good enough for a Force of Will back. I accept this. Wasteland. Presumably they did this whole Sol Ring thing so that they can start making... I don't want this. Let's go ahead and do this now. Oh, wow. Always discard. Always discard. I want to Wasteland the Urza Saga. I don't want to greed this. Because if I greed this trying to get both of these and it doesn't work because my opponent has another Force of Will, all of a sudden, like, there's real bodies that I care about. I think I'm just going to go ahead and take the safer line here. Throw this creature into play. Technically attack first before doing this, but I'm not expecting my opponent to have any plays with 2 colorless mana available. Send him. 6 damage, putting my opponent to 13. I have 7 damage in play. That's a 2-turn clock. My opponent has no colored mana sources. And beyond that, I still will have an active Bazaar. Guess, like, Time Walk into some other nonsense could be good. Soulguide Lantern doesn't really do much right now. My stuff is on board. My opponent may even just cycle it immediately. Depending on, yeah, what their degree of fear is. I'm hoping to just naturally draw a green card for Force of Vigor. I think I kill that. Then I'll activate Bazaar on their turn. I've already used 3 of my Rootwallas, so it's pretty unlikely that I hit exactly like Rootwalla to cast Vengevine and hit my opponent for 11. Alright, send in for a bunch of damage. That'll put my opponent to 5. End of turn, Brainstorm's fine. I hope my opponent doesn't randomly play Tabernacle. Just 1 target. Pitch Vengevine. That is a Force of Will, pitching a misstep. What you got? Using that colored mana is rough. Opponent will have 2 cards left after this. Island Tinker? Alright, we get there. GG's. Okay, this hand doesn't have a Bazaar. We will powder it. This hand doesn't have a Bazaar. I'll go ahead and just mulligan that. And it does have a Bazaar. I will keep that. We'll pitch a Serum Powder here. Call that good. We're probably going to have a very explosive turn 1. I don't have a blue card to pitch to stop whatever awful thing is about to happen. Don't like that. Really don't like that. Really don't like that. Because that means that that enters the battlefield tapped. And since I can't play more than 1 spell each turn, I can never trigger a Vengevine, which is a problem. I still may be able to beat this, but it's gonna be tough, and I can't beat another Wasteland or Stripmine effect, I don't think. Okay, cool, that's fine. Initiative time? Anointed Peacekeeper. Fuck me. That just names Bazaar, and I am fully out of this match. Yeah. I don't think I can possibly win, because that costs a billion mana. Let's concede. This is where we want subtlety, I suppose. This doesn't counter, right? Yes, it is not technically a counter. It gets around Cavern of Souls. Okay. What comes out? Noxious Revival? I don't know. My opponent does have Wastelands. Force of Negation? Force of Negation can probably come out. It, like, is nice at stopping things like Lotus. This doesn't do anything. This does a thing. Don't have a blue card for subtlety, but it's not like I'm throwing this back. Throw back the powder. Basically, I'm just going to look to put Hollow Ones and Vengevines and stuff into play on turn one before my opponent gets a turn. Okay. First of all, how dare you? How dare you? I'll cast that to clear the trigger. That was... Oh, it's still my upkeep. That was not on my bingo card for today, folks. That absolutely was not on my bingo card. Let's pitch 1, 2, 3 here. Pass that creature. Pass a Hollow One. And I have a Force of Will available for something. Is that? I don't think it's that. But it's much more tempting than it looks. Woohoo. Yep. Alright, I have 5 power in play, backed by a counterspell. I need to Force of Will that. It is not immediately a new bazaar. It is not Christmas. And... like, cards are on the table. Ooh. That turns out that forcing that would have been very strong. My opponent kept a pretty ambitious hand. It does things. Okay. No follow-up creature here. My opponent is dead next turn. They could have another swords, in which case they are not dead. But if they don't have removal spells here, it's rough. Okay, yeah, that's fine. Do you want to take out the lizard? Yeah, again, that's fine. It buys my opponent time. So that's something I don't want to see. Now just about anything can come out. Yeah, that's the sort of stuff that I wanted to avoid, because now I can't attack anymore. Unless my opponent attacks, in which case I can. Alright. Bazaar! Fuck. I need so little. I need so little here. I think I'm going in. I think if my opponent just forges up this Seasoned Dungeoneer and just has a larger creature forever, I'm not winning. I'm just going to let them forge up Containment Priest and not spiral out of control with Seasoned Dungeoneer. Yep. Okay, my opponent is going for the Scry side of their deck. Alright. Oh god, not another one. See, this is what I didn't want. I'm going to eat 2 damage this turn, maybe 3. Finding Wasteland, rough. Yeah, I think I'm going to end up just on the wrong side of everything here. Force of Vigor is not what I am looking for. Upkeep, I am going to go ahead and take these things out. Pitching a Once Upon a Time. It's unlikely to matter a lot, but it takes my opponent off of potentially casting some spells. Fuck! It's so bad. Alright. Anointed Peacekeeper. Sure. There is some good news hidden here, and I'll show you all that in a second. Now time for Throne of the Dead 3, and my opponent has Containment Priest. So they don't actually get to dump a creature into play. I will, however, just die to all of this other bullshit, but just wanted to point that out first. GG's. Before our next round here, a quick thank you to Dylan S., Rob C., Rinsky, Bones, and High Contrast for supporting me via Patreon, and to Joe K., Gillum B., Peter L., Stephen T., Timothy F., and Twisted Air for supporting me via YouTube memberships. Thanks so much for the support, folks. I hope you're enjoying the videos, and let's get back to the magic. Alright, no Bazaar will powder it. No Bazaar will mulligan it. As Bazaar, we'll keep it. This is looking like it's going to be a grind hand rather than a murder machine. Bit of serum powder. Bazaar. Activate Bazaar. Nice. Master of Death. We go away. I think I'll keep my Force of Will effect for a turn. And dump Wasteland, keeping Noxious Revival in case my opponent has a Wasteland of their own. Cast HollowVine. Not super impressed by Prized Amalgam from this deck. It gets a blue card that pitches to my Force effects. It's fine in that capacity. But I haven't returned one to play yet. My opponent either has been dead by then, or I just kind of stalled out by then. Oh, okay. That's annoying. I just get rid of that and treat this as a draw two, and my graveyard never gets nuked. I guess. I'm guessing my opponent is an Urza Saga deck. Let's get back some cards. Worth a life to do so for sure. Oh my god. I'll draw two, guard one, two, three, play a new Bazaar. I think I try to hit here. Activate this, guard one, two, three, keep Force of Vigor. All right, let's battle. Okay, that's some powerful artifact mana. That's some powerful mana. Ah, all right, I got vintaged. You have a Sphinx in the main deck, or is it just Bolas's Citadel? Alright, it is Bolas's Citadel. So for the Legacy fans out here, this doesn't see a lot of play in Legacy. It's strong. You can play land and cast spells from the top of your library, and it costs you life equal to that card's value. Or mana value. Okay, so Minamo is for Emery. That's very cute. Ooh, Time Vault in graveyard! Danger! Alright, you get to see my Force of Vigor, which is unfortunate. Although I think I'm probably going for a kill next turn. Just like double activating Bazaars, trying to get that Vengevine into play, maybe a second one. Not guaranteed a green card to pair with Force of Vigor. I would love to get Bolas's Citadel and Manifold Key in upkeep. That is very much not guaranteed to happen. Ooh, a new Emery. Just filling the graveyard some more. Thought Monitor in there. Hull Breacher. Ooh, that's an Ancestral. Oh, it's at 8. Oh, that's a hit. So now it's like, really, is the top card of my library a green card for this Force of Vigor? All right. Let's return these. Green card. Fuck yeah. These aren't happening. I will attack my opponent. You're going to take that hit. Now, do I Force of Vigor on the Bolas's Citadel immediately?
Or not?
Because my opponent just has his Emery in play. They didn't jump block with it. I can wait until they tap mana to put Time Vault into play, and then attack the Time Vault instead. That might be better. Like, my opponent has used their Tinker, I know where their Time Vault is, those are their easiest ways to win in a single turn. I think I let them do stuff, and respond to the stuff. This is fine. Alright, that's targeting the Time Vault. There's a Time Vault. Alright, so they attempt the untap. And I will Force of Vigor, targeting Time Vault. Bolas's Citadel is a lot less scary with the amount of life that my opponent has. I think I'm actually going to target Pithing Needle here as the second one, and just go for the kill in this next turn. If I target Vault and Key at this, that is a Force of Negation. All right, so my opponent has infinite turns. I will just concede to that there. So close. I don't know that I sideboard anything again. Like, my opponent has graveyard-oriented stuff with Emrys that's reasonable. I don't know that I want to fight against it. Like, I wouldn't mulligan to a ley line. I think, like, my normal suite of the 11 free spells here is good enough. This does not have a bazaar. We will powder that hand. I will keep this hand. Got Force of Negation and maybe Force of Vigor. Let's see where this goes. Prized Amalgam. Squee. Wasteland, maybe, as the other discard. Haven't cast a spell yet, so I can cast this once upon a time for free. We're looking for a hollow one. I did not find it. I found a green card to pair with Force of Vigor. So that's okay. This is probably a hand that I end up emptying pretty quickly one way or another. Nah. You don't get that. Cool. Bubble's fine. I'm mostly planning on... when I've seen my second bazaar. I'm mostly planning on playing a slightly longer game with this one. See where it goes. Master of Death is cool. Go ahead and activate this now. Well, let's try to go big. Vengevine. Vengevine. Squee. Second bazaar. Activate. Double Rootwalla is ideal. No creatures. Guard, three Force of Vigors. Keep one Force of Will. I don't know, I kind of like to get the Master of Death back. Let's start discard that, a Force of Will, a Force of Vigor, and just be able to take out multiple permanents from my opponent's side of the battlefield. That'll make me better versus Pithing Needle, which is one of the things that would shut me down the hardest right now. I'm not going after a naked Mox Opal here. We got Time Vault, sure. And a turn. Time Vault. Feet. And I'm just going to try to leave Mox Opal stranded as a card that doesn't do anything. Alright, there is a Force of Will. Go to my upkeep. So if I get these two cards back, I draw a card for turn, I have three, then I have five. Yeah, I'll return these now. I could just die to infinite turns next turn. Does not take a lot here for my opponent to get me. Activate this. Maybe I keep that in hand for a minute. Discard one, two, three. Past that. I can discard this, go up to four, keep one card, which is probably Wasteland. All right, nice. One, two, three. Second Rootwalla gets me two Vengevines. Triggers Prized Amalgam for the first time this league. Second time this league. Wasteland. Wasteland target seat. Go to combat. Attack for eight. Metalcraft is not on. I have lethal on board. Metalcraft turns on if my opponent plays a key, though. Okay. Game on the draw is harder. I have other things I can consider. I don't know how good they are. I think I'm just going to continue as is and hope my free counter spells buy me enough time to close out the game. No bazaar, mulligan. No bazaar. I think mulligan. Bazaar keep. Put two cards back. I want a Master of Death pitch to Force of Will, or a Prized Amalgam to pitch to Force of Will. I think a Rootwalla is going back. I think a Vengevine is going back. Like, I can keep more of those green cards and be better suited to go full aggro, but I think I'm just gonna try not to die to like Tinker or Time Vault, because I am very scared of that. Alright, this could end up being quite strong. Vengevine is going. I think I save the Rootwalla until next turn. I think I go meh. Well, I haven't. Such an awkward time to draw once upon a time, because if I want to cast it, I can't do Rootwalla here. Yeah. Vengevine, Master of Death. We go down. Cast once upon a time. See if I can find like a hollow one to put into play. Negative. Take another blue card that can pitch to a Force of Will. I don't love my position. I might just lose to Construct Tokens. Like, unfair stuff aside. Didn't want to attack Sol Ring last turn because I thought it was too unrealistic that I would take my opponent off of the appropriate amounts of mana. No. I'll force that. Not going to give you two sets of Urza Construct tokens plus a key or worse. Wish I had the fourth Force of Vigor in the 75. All right, back to my turn. Yes. Yes. Okay. That guarantees I can at least put a Vengevine into play this turn. Rootwalla. Rootwalla. We pass both of the lizards. Second one will then trigger Vengevine. Yes. 1, 2, 3. It'll be a 4-4. So my opponent can trade the construct token for this. I don't expect that that's happening here. Yeah, it is not. And I don't know if my opponent has another piece of artifact hate they can fish out, if they're just going to get a key. Got a shadow spear and got a whole nother set of problems to worry about. But I feel like I'm losing. More or less, no matter what the answers to those questions are. It is a needle. My bazaar is off. My opponent has 2 6-6s in play. I'm probably getting bigger. It feels kind of like I can concede here. Oh, I guess I can draw exactly Force of Vigor. No, you don't get that. That's that grows both of those and draws two cards. I think that's too bad for me. Yep, that's fine. Soul Guide Lantern doesn't have real text right now. Like, I have way bigger problems than that card. That is gain 7 life. I accept that. I think upon missing that draw, I'm now dead. I'll stick around for another turn cycle, but like, my plan would have to switch to probably Force of Vigor both construct tokens and then somehow kill my opponent. This is awful. Both are coming in. I'm thinking about whether or not I want to block. I don't think I do. I think the way that I win is taking this damage, drawing Force of Vigor, killing both of those, and then my opponent never does anything ever again. But that didn't happen. GG's. Yeah, I got a bazaar. I'll keep. This is going to do at least a turn one hollow one, if not more than that. Saga on the other side of the battlefield. Force of Negation, an okay pickup here. Okay, yep. Ooh, we got a time walk out of that. That is fantastic. So we will bazaar. Activate bazaar. Ooh. I can get saucy here. Prized Amalgam is going. I think I go Serum Powder. Rootwalla beyond that. Madness this critter into play. Cast a hollow one for free. Pass turn. Upkeep. Nuke Urza Saga just as a tempo play. And very aggressively Force of Negation. Something else. Damn it. Say Libby. Ooh. Is there a card I would want to keep badly enough that I don't just jam second bazaar now? I guess. Well. I mean, yeah, okay. 5 damage, put my opponent to 14. Upkeep, blow up Urza Saga again. I'm all in, but that doesn't seem like a bad thing. Like, this is an insanely fast clock. I think I upkeep activate this here. Guard Serum Powder, Wasteland, probably Master of Death. Punished for the activation in that case. See what my opponent can do. Pick up a Force of Will. That probably means that I don't just immediately activate here. I just force whatever my opponent plays and then activate a Bazaar at their end step. Okay, sure. Yep. I don't think I activate Bazaar now. Vengevine. I mean, I've just got Lethal on board. I'm just going to attack and Force of Will something else if they have something that keeps them alive. Yep. Force of Will, Pitching Master, a Fluster Storm. So before this Hall Breacher is in play, I should activate this. Blah. Guard all of those. Cast. Cast. Barrier Vengevine. Yes. Barrier Prized Amalgam. And this stack can clear. Not paying for anything. My opponent has to chump block HollowVine here. And then I have a lot of power in play, basically, is where we're at. That was technically turn six. It didn't really feel like it because I just restarted the game twice by blowing up Urza Sagas. Okay. Imagine we're playing against some sort of breach type deck again. I don't know, it could just be a Xerox deck, and by that I mean just generic blue, good vintage cards, lots of cantrips. I think I'm just like not sideboarding anything in most of my rounds. I don't know if that's my inexperience with the format or if this sideboard is just geared too heavily in a couple of specific directions. Assuming my opponent does not pithing needle me on turn one, this hand is incredible. I guess with a start like that, they could also tinker me on turn one. Yeah, I do not care about spell bomb. Yeah, don't care about that either. Ooh, that is impressive though. Okay, hold on now. Gimmies are officially rustled. Yeah, you can top. Okay. I get it. You don't want me to fuck around with the graveyard. Like, I understand. Like, message has been received. Cool. Activate this. Force of Vigor is weird. I think I'm interested in that. I think I discard a Rootwalla, Prized Amalgam, and a Master of Death. Go ahead and cast that. Cast some HollowVine, and I'm still going to have Force of Will or whatever actually scary spell my opponent has. So mana crypt damage is super relevant here, by the way, because I have 9 power and 1 failed mana crypt is the difference between this being a 2-turn clock and a 3-turn clock. Yeah, top away. Alright, spell bomb's getting cracked. My opponent has something that they like. Fine. Time walk. I'll bite on that. Like, it's not a tinker or anything, but it's pretty damn good. There's the fluster again. And one more top. Alright, they have drawn a card. Mana crypt. No damage. Floating mana, then fetching. Sure. Wheels here a little bit. Because of that fetch, I am now at an actual 2-turn clock. Brainstorm is fine. I'm looking to dodge something big like Tinker or Time Vault. Those are the things that are going to currently beat me. I'm not worried about something like an Urza Saga. That's just not going to be fast enough. That Hull Breacher is fine. Sure. Then they can do the untap. Draw a second card. Yep. Value. Oh, that's very good. I'm thinking about whether or not I want to take my opponent off of the objectively larger amount of mana, or if I want to take them off of one specific color. This always attacks, this always attacks. This one's a little more questionable. I think I just attack with the HollowVine this time. All right, my opponent takes that. So this takes my opponent off of tutors. Assuming I waste on this, my opponent has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 mana currently showing. I think I'm going to opt to take them off of a color here. Don't want tutors happening. Alright, Mana Crypt, do me some work here. Alright. Op is fine. Again, it's... I assume Tinker and Time Vault that I care about. Alright. Drawn a card. Didn't do the Manifold Key trick this time, which is scary because that could mean Time Vault. Oh, that's just it for my opponent. They're just dead to onboard 4-4s. GG's. So with that, we end this league on a 3-2 finish. Overall thoughts on the deck list? I felt like I was doing a very powerful thing in many of my rounds. I liked what was going on here. I don't know that I like this exact 75. Everything that follows here is me not understanding the current vintage metagame. So take everything that follows here with a grain of salt. I did not feel like I utilized my sideboard space well in this league. I sideboarded very little, and that may just be that my deck is essentially pre-boarded to fight against the blue decks. Like, that may just be how this deck is built. Like, I have the Force of Negations and Force of Wills as protection in game one, and so I'm trying to address other problems in the sideboard. I kind of want one more Force of Vigor in the deck list, and I didn't feel like Prized Amalgam was super good. Like, it was a blue card that pitched to Force of Negation and Force of Will, and that was about the extent of what it did during this league. One other thing that I'll say is I'm not sure to what extent I should have been keeping hands that just have five looks at Bazaar of Baghdad with Once Upon a Time. My inclination was to just chip those hands because the London Mulligan is really strong, but it's possible that I should have more strongly considered some of those opening hands based on like what they were capable of doing if I did hit. I think that's all about all that I have to say here. This seems like a powerful strategy. Like, Bazaar is absolutely one of the pillars of the format. I think I prefer Hogak style decks that actually have some amount of colored mana, because I feel like in any of these rounds, if one of my opponents flopped a Tabernacle of Pendril Veil onto the table, I was just dead. And like, with five actual mana sources in this deck list, I have very little ability to fight against that. But maybe this deck is fine right now if Tabernacle isn't seeing a lot of play. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please click the like button on the way out. It helps out a lot, and I hope you have a great rest of the day. If you have any thoughts about the deck list or the league, feel free to throw them in the comments. See ya!